Just want to just do a kind of a demo of this 67 basement that's that I've rebuilt as a AA 864 circuit in the center channel and kind of a Marshall-y 2203 circuit in the left channel. So kind of give you the best of both worlds. I'm going to I'm just going to play some different styles and some different guitars and just kind of just demo what this thing looks like. I'll also do it right now. I'm plugged directly in the front of the amp. There's no pedal board, no effects, and we will go through with and without some effects and just kind of show you what this amp sounds like with pedals, different guitars, and so on and so forth. So right now I'm playing an 85 Les Paul Flame, and I'm just in the middle channel. I've got the volume on about 4. I'm running some 5881 tubes, power tubes in this amp right now. They break up a little faster than a 6L6 and not quite as much headroom, but just a quick swap out is really all it needs to happen. I've checked the bias on this amp for both types of tubes, and you shouldn't have to adjust anything. So anyway, here we are, bridge pickup. By the way, I might want to add, let me tip the camera down a little bit. The speaker I'm using down here is a, it's just a Dumble clone, kind of oval back cab with a couple of Celestion G65s in it. And two 12s, two 8-ohm speakers running to 4-ohms, and so it's a good match for this head. Anyway, here we go. Turn it all the way up to 10. Right switch on. Back down to livable 5. Right switch off. Neck pickup. Break up a little bit of the 5881s. Like you said, the 6L6s will give you, it actually will make this amp even louder. A little more clean headroom if that's what you're after. A lot of country guys like that. A lot of blues guys like this. You know, it's kind of like, it's your choice. All right, so we're going to switch over here to left channel. This is more of the Marshall-y sound. I got this knob right here. What used to be the volume is now the master. This one on the end become, which I just put into input 2. There's no modification to the chassis. If I just everything wide open, treble on about 2. Brightness. Once you can back this guy down, back the preamp down, set everything 5 and 5. Give you kind of a nice JTM 45 sound. Now realize too, I'm recording all this on an iPhone, so if it sounds good here, then you can imagine if you put a real mic in front of it and did it, you know, like a studio amp. All right, so I'm going to switch guitars real quick. Guy here in town that makes these are really great guitars. I think it's a good guitar for a demo. I'm going to start right back in the middle, 8864 channel, and just real chimey. Great bottom end. Side With these Strats, you know, this is going to be more of the Stevie Ray. So, another guitar to hear this amp with, 66-335. Let's see if it sings a tune. See the cable right here, so you kind of keep track of it. This is just a bone stock, as original as it gets, 66-335, patent sticker pickups in it. I'm gonna come over here to the Marshall side. Man, the reason I like these 5881s is they don't kind of, they're not so clean that they break, they knock your head off. They got a little bit of, you know, your tone has a little bit of hair on it. You know, it's a little broken up, and it sits well with tracks. I'll do that again at the end of this video and kind of just play along with, you know, some blues jam and just kind of let you hear what this thing sounds like with a track. Okay, one last guitar. I'll switch to a Telecaster. For all you Telecaster fans, this is actually a 58 Esquire. And, you know, original everything in it. Maple neck guitar. A little brighter than everything else I've been playing, but I have not touched tone control, so we'll just kind of see if we can hear the difference on the iPhone here. Side. Okay guys, so I'm plugged in my pedal board here. Let me just kind of tilt this thing down, kind of see what I got going on there. Got an M9, you know, Nobles, a couple of my favorite pedals there, volume pedal tuner. EQ is off, and so I'm just going to play through this basement to kind of show you what it might sound like with some pedals here. So I'm just going to start off volume pedals wide open here. And I've got the M9, it's got a little bit of reverb on there. I'm going to play my Strat because it's pretty versatile for sound. Let's see. I made a little delay in there, about 500 milliseconds. A little chorus maybe on top of it. Take pedals extremely good. Back on the Strat tone, again, I'm still playing through the 864 channel. I'm just going to throw a little my mild overdrive pedal in there. Sustained, man. A little heavier overdrive. Say that I have a very light touch of compression in there, as most of us do. Okay, I'm in the Marshall side. Everything's wide open with pedals. Got some reverb, delay, volume's wide open, no EQ, little tiny bit of compression. No overdrive pedal. Pedal with the Marshall channel. Wow, not sure you need all that, but you know, everybody's got something different. Reverb is off. Only thing on. There we are, no effects. I'm gonna add the mild overdrive pedal. Heavy overdrive. Jesus. Well, guys, that is that's kind of the amp with some different guitars, pedal board, no pedal board, so on and so forth. And I hope I've given you a good example of what the 67 Bassman's like. This amp was a complete restoration, stripped down to the bare chassis, and no screw or solder joint was unturned in this. It has all the original Ajax blue caps in it. Original transformers, original preamp tube sockets, one replaced preamp tube socket with a military type, two brand new power amp or power tube sockets. I do that as a preventative measure because those are the guys that go bad. And for some reason lately, I've been replacing a lot of power amp or power tube sockets. I guess, you know, once a 50 year hits, they start going bad. So just to kind of avoid any trouble, all new jacks on the inputs, output for the speakers, pots are original, all brand new cloth wiring. Look at the website, www.emike.net/67Bassman, and we'll have all the teardown pictures there and the process of putting this this beauty together. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll catch you down the road. Thanks.